Life Force promo, Impact of Changing Technology, recorded 4/16/85, aired as scheduled.
Your engine oil pressure is critical.
Be sure to watch The Impact of Changing Technology on Life Force.
Life Force, Impact of Changing Technology, recorded 4/16/85, WI date 4/30/85, other stations aired as scheduled.
Of our lives that are not touched by this marvelous invention. Join me, won't you, as we take a look at the impact of this changing technology.
Elwin, what impact have computers had on the lives of everyday people?
Alberta, the computer has become just an avalanche on our lives. We're wearing them in our watches, on our wrists. We're starting to show up in businesses and in homes, and this has been something that's taken place during the last just couple of years. There are people that are seeing computers operating their television sets, and for the little device that you hold in your hand to tune the channels, we have computer-controlled microwave ovens. They're almost indispensable for operating a business now, and our farmers are finding that if you're going to be progressive and stay with the state of the art, you're not only going to accept computers in your life, but computers are going to be a large part of your operation.
Can we ever get too dependent on computers? You know what I'm thinking of, 2001 and how the computer.
The problem with computers has not been so much as the computers taking over a person's world, or a computer even making things too easy for us. We found that computers are a technology that we have to learn how to use. Just as the automobile became very common around the time of the Second World War, and at the time it was over, when almost every family in the United States began to think of the automobile as a necessity rather than as a luxury. And we had a technology we had to learn. We had to learn to use it well. We had to learn to apply it. We had to learn the economics of it. Now we've got a computer that's the same challenge. Just as the automobile may have had some adverse effects, such as with safety and with physical health and conditioning in our lives, the computer may have some adverse effects. But overall, we've got a challenge of a new machine to learn to master so that it can fill an important part in our lives and our success in business and our general happiness in the way we do things in our lifestyle.
Elwin, how do computers affect us indirectly?
The indirect use is maybe a little bit more subtle, but all around us we see examples of it. One that I'd like to point out in some detail is the information that we receive, particularly some of the specialized information. From the State Extension Service and the Cooperative Extension at Iowa State University, we have a very substantial effort to bring state-of-the-art information of an operational nature to farmers and farm businesses and to other aspects of life in Iowa. This information, to be delivered in a timely manner and promptly, is delivered with the aid of computerized systems. One of these systems that has become very important to many of the farmers in the state of Iowa is the Agricultural Infodata Service, a service that is created by Iowa State University's Cooperative Extension together with Iowa Public Television to bring printed information on the screen of television sets into the homes of everyone that would care to see it. The preparation of this information is done largely with the aid of computerized systems. Also, the delivery into the home requires that a small computerized adapter be purchased and attached to a normal home television so that this important information can be received.
What is AIDS?
AIDS is a new way of distributing information to the farmers here in Iowa. As you know, this with the new advances in technology, farmers need to be more market-orientated and less production-orientated, and they need that information to make decisions. And this new system, the Agricultural Info Data Service, is a way of providing that information to them on a very timely basis. The information is collected here locally from extension services, such as agricultural climatology, extensions integrated pest management, and extensions market news. That is then typed into a microprocessor and sent via telephone line to Iowa Public Television. There it's transmitted as a TV signal and sent out to anyone who has purchased a telecaption converter can pick up this information, and it just appears on the TV set as text, and they can then use it to make wiser decisions, I guess.
Ken, how current is this information?
Well, on the futures prices, the information is usually about anywhere from a half hour to an hour old. On the livestock reports, cash livestock reports that we give, they're often immediate. As soon as we get them off the wire service, they're typed into the microprocessor and sent to Iowa Public Television for broadcast. So the information is about as current as we can possibly make it.
So then the farmer who's speculating in futures could use this information?
No, I'm afraid not. It's not up-to-minute reports on the futures prices. We're more aiming at the audience, an audience such as the hedgers here in Iowa, farmers who are wishing just to keep up on the markets and hedging their crops.
What has been the response of Iowans to this new service?
The response has been tremendous. The people who've called in and used this service have said they found it very, very, very helpful, and that they found it to be a very wise expenditure of their tax dollar. And I've had several farmers comment that they've paid for the service in just a couple marketing trips. Selling cattle, getting a few dollar a head more because they knew what the price was.
Ellen, what are the new technologies other than computers that are used in obtaining information for farm operations?
Not too many years ago, it was discovered that female insects attract male insects by what's known as a pheromone. And having discovered that, it wasn't too long until our biochemists had developed pheromones artificially, opening a whole new world of being able to determine when insects had infested a location. When we have this type of information, we have information that is very important to be distributed very quickly to the farm producers, both the chemical salespeople, the people that apply chemicals to protect our crops, and to the farmer who has got a vested interest in crop protection.
What are some of the modern methods used in trapping insects?
Well, one of the modern methods that we use here at Iowa State University, and in fact across most of the Midwest is a relatively new approach with something called a pheromone. A pheromone is simply a perfume-like substance that that will attract an insect or alter its behavior. So what we do, we've taken advantage of this perfume-like substance or pheromone. We've put it in a white trap, as you see here. This trap will capture black cutworm moths. By simply hanging these traps in the trees then in early spring, we can then determine when the first arrival or first flight of black cutworm moths arrive in Iowa. And by knowing that then, we then can predict actually now where and when black cutworms will be a problem in Iowa. So by knowing when the cutworms come in, we can tell a farmer, you will have a problem with cutworms, and we can tell another farmer, you will not have a problem with cutworms.
How is this pest information obtained in Iowa?
Our pest information in Iowa is obtained from many different sources. We rely upon IPM, or Integrated Pest Management Scouts. We rely upon information from industry scouts, from private consultants, from other personnel within the state, in and outside of Extension. And the information then is taken actually from the fields on a regular basis, at least once a week throughout the crop reporting season. It's taken then every week and sent from all of these sources back to Ames to our computer here on campus so then that we can turn this information around and send it back to the public.
Jerry, how is insect pest information delivered to farmers and businesses?
Well, in Iowa, we have a large variety of people who want this type of information, crop, pest, weather information. So we have a wide range and variety of methods of delivering this information. We have radio shows live each day over the noon hour, which allow us then to give the very latest information to the public. Just as it's happening, we then can broadcast it statewide. We also have a computer network. Individuals, farmers, the co-ops, the independent dealers, those who have their computers can call up any time, night or day, and receive the very latest information in a matter of minutes on what the weather will be, what the latest insect or pest problem is for their area of the state. We also have a tape-recorded message that one can call up and receive a 60-second idea of what's happening statewide. We have newsletters, for example, that we send out weekly. And last, we have something called the Agricultural Info Data Service, or what we commonly call AIDS, which allows us to put information out in the hands of anyone who has a television, put this out in a matter of minutes. They can receive the very latest information statewide.
These days, marketing the crop is just as important as growing it. What assistance is offered to farmers along these lines?
We would certainly be remiss if we didn't talk about the effort that has been placed into getting market reports and some analysis of what may be affecting the prices that farmers can receive for their produce. We have an extensive program at Iowa State University, not only to distribute market reports and information, but to produce that information. Largely through the efforts of Dallas McGinnis, we have developed a state-of-the-art method of obtaining information, compiling it into a form the farmers can use, and then using the latest technologies to distribute it to the producers throughout our state.
Dallas, how do you gather market information and get it on the air? And I'm talking both radio and AIDS.
Well, we have a lot of machines that help us. We have Reuters News Service. We have a direct contact with USDA through a machine. And we also have the Commodity News Service. With the use of this equipment and by using the telephone and reaching certain people that we want to reach a little sooner than it gets on this equipment, we get out the market information.
We. Who's we?
Well, there's myself, and then Jane Schwartz has been working with me for about 10 years, and she's a secretary and just a general do everything, does some broadcasts, posts a lot, talks to a lot of people to keep them happy while we get information from them, which we want to thank them for. And then we have three students right at the present time. I usually have two or three students assisting, Rick Robinson, also have Jeff Gregg and Paul Ward.
Okay. What service does AIDS render that was not offered in the past?
Well, when you're talking about AIDS, that's a method to get market information by the printed method instead of listening to it on the radio. The good thing about that is a farmer or anyone else, a bank or anyone who's wanting to get market information can see it practically all the time. For the radio, you had to be there at a certain time and get it at that moment, and if you didn't get it then, you missed it. I say that, but we used to have some pretty ingenious people, still do. A lot of them did record the radio markets, too. That made it available to them, even though they weren't there. But AIDS is really a written message, and it's there when they want it. And we have financial information now. That dollar dropped sharply yesterday. Dollar fell to 2.74.5 West German marks to the dollar at the close yesterday. It's recovered some from that and is now at 2.75.25. A belief that U.S. interest rates will not rise and may even move lower has injected a very negative tone.
Can you remember what it was like before all this high technology?
I guess I can. I grew up on a farm in southern Iowa in the late 20s, early 30s. We still had horses down there then, grew our own fuel. Our automobile, of course, used gasoline, but it was one of those simple kind of cars. You could take care of yourself. You knew how to take it apart and put it back together. Can't do that with all this high-tech motors and engines today. A lot simpler with the horses, but a lot more difficult, too. It's cold out there, bringing in hay from a stack or getting shocks of corn in from the field and feeding cattle in the cold of the winter and that sort of thing. A lot of things are really disadvantaged there. Remember our first radio and what that brought to our home in the way of information and entertainment. I remember when there wasn't much technology.
Farming involves hard physical labor, but it also involves detailed record keeping, and that's